Hello everyone, in this video I will be discussing about types of memories and my name is Ms. Surbhi Saroha. First of all, memory, there are three types of primary memories basically which I use in computer. Number one is cache memory, then primary memory, we also call it as main memory, then secondary memory. Cache memory is a very high speed semiconductor memory which can speed up the CPU. So of course actually cache memory is used to speed up the CPU performance, so we get a result very fast. Actually what it is a buffer between the CPU and the main memory. So it acts as a buffer between the CPU and the main memory. What does buffer means? Buffer means a mediator. It is in between CPU and the main memory, which is the physical memory. It is used to hold those parts of data and program which are most frequently used by the CPU. So actually what is there in the cache memory? Those things which the user use most often in his computer. The parts of data and programs are transferred from the disk to cache memory by the operating system from which the CPU can access them. So the part of data and program that is in the cache memory. Okay. Now, what is the advantage of cache memory? Number one is, as I already told you, that cache memory is faster than main memory. Actually, it is basically used to, you know, give the fast output to the user. It consumes less access time as compared to main memory. It stores the program that can be executed within a short period of time. It stores data for temporary use. And of course, the data stored in cache is always on temporary basis. Disadvantage of cache is cache memory has limited capacity. It is very expensive and of course the cost is very high of cache memory. Then we move to primary memory, which is also known as main memory. Primary memory holds only those data and instructions on which the computer is currently working. So this is very important, only those data and instructions in which the computer is currently working. It has a limited capacity and data is lost when power is switched off. So the data is lost. This is the case of actually primary memory includes two memories. One is RAM and another is ROM. RAM is the full form is random access memory and ROM is read only memory. So whenever we write something, you know, and when the light is, you know, when the light disconnects, so RAM get whatever we have saved in RAM gets, erased, right? So it is generally made up of semiconductor device. These memories are not as fast as registers. So they are not as fast as registers. What is register? Register is also a kind of storage medium. The data and instructions required to be processed resides in the main memory. And whatever the data and instruction required to be processed, that always stays in the main memory. And as I told you, the next point is that only it is divided into two subcategories. One is RAM, another is ROM. So they are the two main primary memories: random access memory and read-only memory. Next we come to secondary memory. Now what is secondary? First, if we give a quick recap of what we have done, the types of memory consist of cache memory, then main memory, then secondary memory. Secondary memory is auxiliary memory, like we have CD, we have DVDs. So these are all the secondary memories in which we store data on external. It is also known as external memory. Okay, this type of memory is also known as external memory or non-volatile. Non-volatile means once the data is stored in it, it will never get erased. It is non-volatile. It is slower than the main memory, and of course the speed is slower then in comparison to main memory. In main memory we have RAM and ROM. These are used for storing data information permanently. So data is stored permanently here. CPU directly does not access these memory. Instead, they are accessed through input-output routines. So the CPU does not have a direct control over secondary memory. The contents of secondary memories are first transferred to the main memory and then the CPU can access this away. First of all, the contents are transferred to the main memory and then to the secondary. For example of, as I've already discussed, the example of secondary memory is CD-ROM. CD means compact disc, ROM means read-only memory. DVD full form is digital versatile disc, so etc. These are all part of secondary memory. Thank you. I hope this video is beneficial for you and you understand the types of memories. Thank you. Have a nice day.